Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call to order the Police Community Advisory Committee meeting for December 6, 2017. We'll have the Pledge of Allegiance led by our committee member, Jose Mendoza.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Patel?
Present.
Mr. Lacy? Mr. Mendoza?
Present.
Mr. Lynch?
Here.
Mr. Metcalf?
Here.
Mr. Perez?
Present.
Mr. De La Rosa?
Here.
Thank you. This meeting is now open to general public comments. Floor is open to for an opportunity for the public to make their comments to the committee and staff. If you will, please remember this is not a question and answer period. Questions can be addressed after the meeting at the committee and staff's discretion. Comments are generally limited to 3 minutes per speaker. We may further limit the time for public comment depending on the agenda schedule. Inappropriate language will not be tolerated. And please remember, this meeting is being broadcast live on television. Public comments? Mr. Kennedy.
Good evening. Stephen Kennedy, resident of Salinas. On November 29th, I sent an email to the chief, and it was really after the previous meeting that there was a presentation by one of the officers regarding using cameras, and I think they purchased a couple of portable camera units. My understanding, those may be used in areas, they may be placed in areas that, you know, you see a unit there with a camera on it, and it's the deterrent factor may take effect, but it really doesn't capture anything that may take place because you're notifying criminals or people that may want to shoot somebody up. That's probably not the place to do it. What my email said was that using conventional high-definition, low-light cameras and having them placed in future, you know, based on regressive analysis regarding where maybe the last 5 years where homicides or attempted homicides have taken place, they can map that, they have that information. They put these permanent stationary cameras in public right-of-ways, and that will help solve the clearance, low clearance rate that this city has in the low 20s on the basis of proving a homicide or at least finding a subject that a perpetrator. So when you do that, you probably, after a while, you'll find evidence of maybe a car that's driven by, camera will pick that up, maybe even individuals, and it becomes a critical witness for detectives, and you need those leads. It is something that I really I'll put together a report for this commission, for this committee, but I'll also send it to the city council members regarding what other cities have already put together, you know, from local and also throughout the state of California, and what that's done to their clearance rates. But we don't have witnesses because if it's gang-related, I'm not going to testify. I'm sorry. Because I want to protect my family. I don't want retribution, possible retribution by gang members. So you need to capture that information, and the city has a major problem with that process now of having witnesses. And I think that their clearance rates will skyrocket when they have these leads. So I'll try to get that to you. I'm still working on it. I'll update it regarding local, what Seaside, what King City has done, what some other places have done. But the main thing is that it's worked. London, England, I think they got 200,000 cameras throughout their city. Anyway, I'll let you just, I'll talk to the chief some more about it. I know that they're working on things. Maybe we can get grant money from G Major, maybe some other grant areas as well, if they don't have enough in their budget. Mm-hmm. Okay? Thank you very much.
Thank
Appreciate
you, sir.
It.
Any other comments from the public? Seeing none, we'll close this portion of the meeting. Next, we want to approve and or amend the minutes from our October meeting. I trust we've all read these. Do we have any approval or amendments? If not, we need a motion to approve.
I make a motion to approve the previous minutes.
Thank you. Second, please.
I'll second.
Thank you. Chase, would you take a roll call to approve these minutes?
Mr. Patel?
Aye.
Mr. Lacey?
Aye.
Mr. Mendoza?
Aye.
Mr. Lynch?
Yes.
Mr. Metcalf?
Yes, aye.
Mr. Perez?
Aye.
Mr. De La Rosa?
Aye.
It is unanimous.
Thank you. We were hoping to have the chief's report at this time. She's unavailable tonight. If all goes well, we'll hear from her next meeting, which will be January 21st. For future agenda items, if anyone wishes to have an item appear on the future agenda, you're welcome to tell us now.
I actually had a thought early on. I don't know if this is possible, but is it possible to get copies of current police procedures and maybe the budget? So I don't, this is knowledge information that we can have access to. That way we can kind of better understand police procedures and the allocation of funds within the department. I don't know if that's something we could put on for the next agenda, next meeting.
Okay, and I think that would be also fall well under a committee member comments, so we can do both. Yeah. Any other future agenda items? Leo?
Yes, I have two of them. It's been running around my head. And maybe she can explain to us and tell us how it's going to be. I understand the police department received a grant for, I think, some $180,000 or so. And that was supposed to be used for people that drive too fast. Okay, what runs around my head is that money, okay, based on the situation police department is in, not enough officers. Now, by having that money, is it really, how is you going to do it to catch those speeders? Okay, that's my question.
Okay.
That's one. The other one is the spray, Narcan. Is she planning on training the officers to be able to save lives using the Narcan, or what is her plan on that?
Okay, thank you, Leo. Any other future agenda items? Mr. Patel.
Thank you, Chairman. I would like to open a discussion dialogue regarding the placement of cameras throughout the city. I think technology has reached a point coupled with lower cost that maybe we should be reevaluating our current assessment on the viability of camera systems, you know? I think we really should look at it and look at other models and see if they have been successful throughout our state. And, I would entertain the thought of even going to check a couple of the cities out and see what's going on. You know, that's part of our role is to go out and see what's going on. And so, yes, I would like to see that on the discussion table if possible as an agenda item. Thank you, Chairman.
You're welcome. Thank you, sir. Any other future agenda items, Omar?
Kind of just to piggyback on that, I also want to start kind of a dialogue on a discussion on body cams. I've actually recently read a report done by a department of the UK government on the effectiveness on body cams, and I would like to open up a discussion on body cam usage in our department and the effectiveness of body cams. Thanks.
Thank you. Seeing no more future agenda items, we'll close this portion. Next, we are opening to committee member comments. Each committee member is welcome to make comments. I'll start with Mr. De La Rosa.
Yes, if possible, I think you mentioned if we can get a. I came to the council meeting last night, and Mr. Serrano gave a report on citations. Is it possible that we could get, on top of what he mentioned, a report on that, see where we're at? That's what I would like to see, if possible.
Okay, Mr. Perez, comments?
Just a quick comment, kind of going back on the body cam thing, just a really brief kind of conclusion on that report. The report indicated that it improved decision-making within the police force, but also provided somewhat of a safety, security, sense of security within the police officers using it. So definitely would like to see some kind of evaluation. I just kind of can piggyback that on the effectiveness and how safe our officers feel carrying around a body cam, as well as its effectiveness on making sure that procedures are followed within our department's role.
Thank you. Mr. Metcalf, comments?
No comments.
Mr. Patel, comments?
First of all, just a quick comment on the SROs in Santa Rita District. I just want to compliment our two officers and the excellent building of bridges of trust that is occurring right now in our district. And, you know, they just went up for training over in Gilroy. For you know, various situations that do occur in the public and public school air systems, and so I'm glad that we're getting training to handle all the different types of situations that can occur to ensure the safety of all of our residents, especially our youngest. So I'm very pleased with the implementation of the SRO program. Second, I have talked to my city council member, who I am representing, and regarding the idea of possibly changing the name, he is in complete agreement that we should support our chief of police and this measure of moving forward with this idea of community policing strategies. And this terminology is, I think, is a big deal, along with this idea of how do we get the community involved. So I just want to reiterate that fact. The third thing I just want to mention, and this tails with Mr. De La Rosa's statement earlier, we did receive a grant. I think it was a little over $150,000, I believe. My suggestion to the chief would be, and to our city council, is I think those dollars could be wisely spent doing an all-out media campaign. I think we are at the moment in time where we have limited officers. I agree with Mr. De La Rosa that how are we going to make sure that these dollars are well spent and achieving the target of reducing speeds and safety. And we've had a rash of incidents of late of mothers dying on the street trying to walk their children across. And I think we really need to implement a public media campaign with these dollars to make sure that all of our residents understand what's happening on the streets. You know, I think now is the perfect time. I think it's in the spotlight. I think people are aware of the deadly situations that have occurred. I think now is the time. There's always certain times in history where, you know, it's probably the best time to do something. And I think now is the time to go all out and spend those dollars wisely on a public media campaign. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Lacey, comments?
No comment at this time. Thank you.
You're welcome. Mr. Mendoza, comments?
Yes, I have one one comment, Mr. Chairman, and it pertains to the ongoing gang violence, teen homicides we've been having. As you guys know, there's been numerous articles over the last 2-3 years where Salinas, California has been declared the teen homicide capital of California. And it looks like we're gonna be number one again this year. About a week and a half ago, we had a homicide on the east side off 2nd Avenue. And I just find that unacceptable. One of the things that I kind of found disheartening was the lack of empathy from our city council, our chief of police, or anyone for that matter, because as far as I'm concerned, I didn't see any press release or a news segment where the chief or a city council member got on TV and basically, you know, voiced their concerns. And as we've been talking over the last few months, we've been trying to build bridges with our community, gain their trust, trying to build up our attendance. And over this last month, as I've been talking to some of the community members, whether it's at the grocery store, gas station, while I'm walking my dog, one of the common things that I heard was that the community feels like the police department, the chief of police, doesn't really care about their concerns. Once again, 2017, we've had 28 young Latino males become victims of gang violence. And we've kind of become numb, if you will, to it. As far as the $150,000 grant we just got, we need to reprioritize our priorities. I just don't see us spending $150,000 on speeders instead of really coming up with some sort of anti-gang program or bringing in officers on a specific period on overtime and just, you know, hitting those high crime areas. I wish the chief would have been here today, but it'd be nice if, you know, our chief would put out a little blurb on TV and let the community know, you know, we know what's happening, you know, it's unacceptable, even though, and I believe some of the public in the past has stated, because I'm also tired of hearing it, you know, we don't have the staffing and so forth, you know. The community is also tired of hearing that same excuse over and over again. And it's time to think out of the box, get creative, and really, you know, fight this ongoing gang problem. As far as the cameras, I'm in total agreement with Mr. Kennedy. I believe about a year ago, the city of Soledad spent about $100,000 to install, I believe it was up to 50 cameras within the city limits of Soledad. And within their first couple of days, I believe there was an incident where a small child was abducted. They were able to find the vehicle and the baby as a result of the cameras, because they saw the direction of travel that it was going, and eventually I believe they caught him here in Salinas. So that's another option. Instead of spending the money on speeders, maybe we should invest that money towards a camera program. And lastly, one of the other things I would like to request, at least for a future agenda item, or at least open up a discussion, is I believe the panel, we've been on the panel for about a year now. And I'm just curious to see, at least from the police department's side, what accomplishments they have done this year. I want to see what's the difference between January of 2017 to now and see maybe where we need to, you know, do more work on or maybe reprioritize for 2018. Maybe the chief of police could provide us with some sort of report. That's it.
Thank you. My comments have to do with a couple of phone calls and emails I was sent with regard to school drop-off and pickup of kids. It seems to be, from the position of the people that contacted me, a very unsafe situation. I would have shared this with the chief. I'll do so in the future. One that troubled me most was a lady contacted me saying that the parents in the morning parked their car in front of somebody's driveway. She was trying to get out, and a police officer was there and refused to do anything. And this particular person that contacted me was extremely upset because no police action was taken. So I'll be glad to share that with the chief. Also, I would have been willing, and I'm willing, to talk about another person that contacted me. They saw over at the DMV what looked like a body laying on a bench. So this person called the non-emergency number. Police were dispatched, and this person could see from her window across at the DMV, and the police didn't even get out of their car. And the police left, and then about 10 minutes later, a fire department showed up, and they drove around and didn't even approach what appeared to be a body. So eventually the woman called the PD again. This time they came out for the second time, and finally an officer got out of his car and tapped it. It happened to be, fortunately, a discarded sleeping bag. And the lady's concern was that it took so long to get somebody to actually pursue and investigate this situation. It could have been a human that needed help, or perhaps even someone that was dead. So these are concerns that I'll be happy to share with the chief when she and I get together. Those are my comments. Our next meeting is scheduled for January 31st. I wish everyone a safe and pleasant holiday. This meeting is adjourned.